Hey guys, what's up? Scorch A2 here with a special guest today from GameAnyone.com. I have Dave the Usher with me for Lara Croft and the Guardian of Light. Say hi, Dave.
Hey, hey.
Hey, hey. So, this is actually a neat little platformer game that's developed by Square, Eidos, and Crystal Dynamics. That's along the lines of the Tomb Raider series, but not in the same style. It's a top-down adventure game built with puzzles and meant for multiplayer. It's a downloadable title that was released for the Xbox Arcade back in August, I think, and it was just released on the PS3 and PC, so I decided to pick it up and play it. And now Dave's gonna join me for this epic awesomeness.
I'm Lara Croft. I wear bicycle shorts. Look at me. I want to be taken serious. Like my male associates. But how can I with all this cleavage?
Alright, so I've had a chance to play through this a couple of times before. I actually had to set up another profile so that I could have a brand new save, because games are stupid when they don't let you have more than one save. So we're going to play on... subtitles on, and we're going to play on hard mode. What do you like that, Dave? We're going to play on hard.
Hard.
Dave likes it hard, he told me.
A hard drink.
Display
something
calibration.
Hard and strong.
Yeah. There's going to be a little bit of a cutscene here. Here's our score challenges. I'll explain those in a little bit.
According to Aztec myth, the region we call the Yucatan is an ancient battleground where the human followers of Totec, the Guardian of Light, once waged a catastrophic war against the demonic forces of Zolot, the Keeper of Darkness. It is written that Zolot called upon the power of an artifact known as the Mirror of Smoke to summon forth a horde of unspeakable horrors from the abyss. Totec's warriors were slaughtered in the battle that followed, but Totec himself survived. He found a way to turn the mirror's power back against the evil god. Zolot was imprisoned within the mirror, and the descendants of Totec went on to forge a mighty empire that lasted until the arrival of the conquistadors. As for what happened to the Mirror of Smoke, the ancient texts are vague. Some say it was hidden in a secret place, that the mirror was lost forever. But if there's one thing I've learned, it's that nothing is lost forever. And here it is. After weeks of hiking through the treacherous Central American jungle, I finally found the Mirror of Smoke. It isn't much to look at, but that's something else I've learned. Appearances can be deceiving. Apparently these guys know it too. Meet Vasco, the local warlord. Vasco has been after the mirror for years, but he couldn't find it. Not without my help, anyway. I guess Vasco doesn't read much either. He doesn't seem to know about the curse. Or maybe he just doesn't believe it.
Zolo, face me!
You are not worthy, Totec.
Have you forgotten the last time we met in battle?
A new day is dawned, and soon, night will fall on this world for the last time.
You know not the darkness you have unleashed. Zolot will drown this world in blood.
No need to be dramatic. Surely there's a way to set this right.
Zolot must be imprisoned within the mirror and returned to this place before the light of dawn. It is the only way to stop him. Stand back. This is no job for a woman.
Perhaps you should stand back. Unless you want to singe that pretty skirt of yours. Step away from that door, or this bomb is going to hurt more than your pride. This is my kind of magic. Just put it down and get out of the way.
What do you think about that, Dave? The story that you couldn't hear.
She better put that back.
Better not do it.
Better do it.
Better not.
She better do it, man.
So that's the remote bombs that she was talking to us about. We get to blow shit up.
And, bicycle shorts.
Yeah. So Dave couldn't hear it, but that voice of Totec, that guy that's with me, he's Jim Cummings. He did a lot of Disney shit.
Well, that's sorted.
Sup, Tigger?
Now, let's go and find your ugly friend.
Pitching Ace should know that guy.
I hear all.
Ha ha ha. Look at this, dead guys. So, little bit of explanation here real quick, for myself and Dave's benefit, and for the likes of you as well. So I'm going to go ahead and show the objectives real quick. Each level has a set of challenges that you can accomplish to get special items that you can equip and make your character more powerful. So each level you have a certain set of conditions that are either specific to that level or specific to every level. Like beating it within a certain time or getting a certain score, collecting a bunch of items, blowing some shit up. You know, whatever it is. So I'll be striving to do a good majority of those as I play through, so that way you can kind of see how it's done. And some of it just because I like to torture myself with a thumb up my ass. What do you think about that?
Usually it's two.
Two?
Three?
Three? Ooh. Use R to draw and aim your weapons. While guns are drawn, hold down R2 to continuously fire your weapon. Hold L to strafe while aiming and firing. So this is a dynamic that it's kind of a pain in the ass to get used to, but once you do, it's actually kind of neat. It's gonna go cause some carnage.
Whoa! Stop that! You're ruining those pots, man! Someone made those!
Yeah, well, you know what? There's no one around to catch me, so...
Fuck it. Person's probably dead now, but I don't think they would appreciate you just breaking all that shit, man. Someone had to make it. Someone makes this stuff.
I know. Someone goes through the trouble of...
Stop that!
...decorating, and you're just blowing it all up.
Boy, look at me! I'm rolling around!
Yeah.
I like to roll fancy. Is that really necessary? You know, you don't have to do that.
In all honesty, really?
2,000 years in this prison. Now I will bathe in your blood. If you continue to pursue Solote, he will kill you like the rest.
Well, I'll just have to take my chances.
You're being foolish. If you must continue, take this for your journey. It was forged by the gods, and holds great power.
A bit old-fashioned, but I'm sure I can find some use for it.
I wish you good fortune.
Alright, now we got a spear. You like spears, don't you, Dave?
I like to use the spear. It's my favorite weapon.
Yeah.
That crazy spear guy running his mouth.
Yeah. Show you what for.
Oh! Ouchies!
Oh, dear lord.
He got speared.
He did. So, this game is actually a multiplayer, Dave.
Oh, is it?
It is. But...
Scorch, I do believe that the weapon that you're using right now, it's called the Clogmonger, right? Isn't that the ancient spear of Zeus?
The ancient Clogmongerus. So, actually, the online multiplayer was left out of this version for whatever reason, though, so that's kind of lame. But at some point, eventually, you can play online.
Whoa.
Yeah.
What am I looking at now?
It's teaching you how to spear jump, so you can throw your spears into the wall.
Holy hell!
Holy, see, look at this. Let's do it again. Instant replay. There you go. Health refill? Anybody like that? More pods to destroy because I'm an asshole.
She's a jump. Oh, no, no! Oh, God, stop doing that! Come on! Like a little kid.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Stop breaking things. Someone had to make that.
You're fucking. So, Dave, did you ever play any of the Tomb Raider games? You're a console guy, huh?
Barely.
Barely? Yeah, me either.
The first couple.
I played the first one on PS1, I think, or PC.
Yeah, first couple on the PlayStation 1.
Yeah, I didn't really get into it, honestly.
I never really got into the series either.
Yeah. Did you see any of the movies? Oh, Grapple Climb.
Yes I did. Saw the first one.
Yeah, I think my uncle took me to see it when he came here to visit one time. Like, I didn't have any interest in it, went with him anyway. It was alright. If you like Angelina Jolie. Or if you're a nerd and you actually like the game, I mean, you know, one of those things. There's nothing wrong with being a nerd, is there?
She's a jumper.
A jumper, you know. So those red things I'm collecting are red skulls. They have 10 of them in every level, and if you collect them all, you get a special bonus.
Who has a red skull?
I don't know. I'm kind of wondering what happened. Like, were they really angry? Like, agitated?
Did they paint or dye the skulls?
Maybe they knew Vol.
Were they extremely frumpy and grumpy when they died? Which caused their heads to turn red?
I'm gonna bet on it.
The blood flowed the skull.
The blood flowed and it sort of leaked out, and there you are.
Are we still talking about skulls?
I think so. Why, what are you talking about?
I don't know, I just heard touching, leaked out.
Started to get hot. So that was a health item I just picked up. Health items are good. This game reminds me of Gauntlet, but with more puzzle aspects. Did you ever play Gauntlet, Dave, like on the N64 or in the arcade with your friends?
I gotta say no.
Or the NES, actually, because that's what the first system was. That was a fun game. I played it on the N64 for the first time, and I used to have all my friends come over and we'd play that all the fucking time. Way mindless.
And then we would watch the Montel Williams show.
I used to do that back in the day. I feel so lonely now. Get our spear out. Throw it right at the skull.
Oh, right.
Oh yeah. Yeah, we'll blow this shit up. So yeah, this game is actually meant to be played with two players, but obviously you can see
these
we're playing it with only
were
one.
Once used by
she can't fly,
to
right?
Improve their skills in battle.
No. You better not be able to. Artifact. We just got an artifact. An artifact is like, you know, like Final Fantasy shit. You know, you equip it and it does stuff for you. It makes you awesome. It makes your clogmonger bigger. That's how you roll. I don't know. How do you roll?
Well, she could use a bigger spear, I guess.
Spear of Zeus. Zeusmonger. I'm collecting diamonds, because I am
there's green shit!
This green shit is like Soylent Green. It's made out of
you're
people.
Collecting diamonds?
Yeah, I'm a green...
Just, like,
I'm
scattered
a,
around?
I'm a greedy slut.
Come on, sloppy. Like, collect that shit, put it in a bucket somewhere.
Do you have infinite pockets going on here?
Are those the cannons from Super Mario World? Yeah. What is that?
Bullet Bill.
Whoa! Look at these guys! They look a tad ropey.
Get a load of these fuckers.
The guy has a spear through his chest, I think.
You got a dart in your neck, man. Let's go bowling. You can use the remote bombs to move these bowling balls.
Oh god!
See? It's awesome. Look at that. Don't you wish you could do that? Move balls around with your mind.
I used to be able to do that in my youth.
In my younger days, I could bomb with balls. So Dave, tell the viewers, what have you been doing now that you're done with some of your big projects?
Well, I've just been reading more. I've been going out on walks on the beach, took up surfing, gardening, farming, agriculture, you know, the norm.
Know the norm. Long walks on the beach.
Getting into some new stuff, man, you know? My portfolio. Getting stronger.
My portfolio. I'm gonna jump across these spider pots because you get a, you get some shit if you do it.
If you jump across the, you get shit. What do you get? What could you possibly get from jumping from one to one?
It just materializes.
That sounds horrible.
Horrible and rude. Made it. You got a power up, Dave. A power up.
Lara Croft.
An overachiever. We got a trophy. Yay. We can wall run.